Welcome to Pixotope Academy. Today we'll be discussing how to upgrade to our latest release 2.0, as well as walk through the new features and changes to the workflow. With 2.0, you're now able to install different versions of Pixotope in parallel. This way you can try out new features without jeopardizing your main Pixotope installation. We do not recommend that you upgrade your Pixotope machines in the middle of a production or pre-production phase, as this version upgrades the Unreal Engine to version 4.27. Please check our known bugs and limitations for 2.0 at support.pixotope.com. To upgrade to 2.0, we'll start by logging into Pixotope Cloud and navigating to the downloads either in the side menu or using the quick link provided on the homepage. When you first open Director, you'll be prompted to select the role for your machine. The role selection acts similar to choosing to run or connect to a data hub in the prior versions of Pixotope. However, the role selection also defines where the setup data is stored. Roles are used to clearly define the responsibilities of your machine in Pixotope Network. However, a machine is not locked to this specific role, and you can easily change its role under machine settings. Standalone. Choose this role for a single machine production. This is the only choice when using an artist license. Client. Choose this role for all machines which connect to a server and work on the server's open show. Server. Choose this role for the machine in a multi-machine production which stores or owns the show file. A server accepts connections from all machines. Our data hub communication has been completely rewritten and is now based on a publisher-subscriber model. All changes made in the Director are now kept completely in sync. Finally, you can use Director from any machine you like. Pixotope's Director is designed with a virtual production workflow in mind. It's built around the main steps of production, reflected in its different views. In 2.0, we're introducing the Start view. Here you can browse and select a show to work on, and adjust the machine-specific settings of your desktop. Once you select a show from the Start menu, the setup and production views will be unique to that specific show, and store its setup configuration in that show file. Setup. This is dedicated to the initial technical configuration of your system, such as tracking and video routing. The production view is meant for the day-to-day operations. Here's where users are able to adjust, manipulate, and trigger graphical elements during a live broadcast. The Shows panel in Start view lists all your local shows. Here you can create, open, and manage your shows, as well as change machine role and other machine-specific settings. To accommodate the diverse ways productions are set up, we introduce the control modes for setup and production. These modes combine flexibility and safety in whatever way you work. The status panel got an upgrade to give you a better overview of all connected machines and their main services. It now lets you see all connected machines with the server machine on top. Here you can manually restart the tracking and video I/O services and close and reload running levels. In 2.0, we introduced the concept of a show file where all setup view related parameters of a project are stored, along with a link to the project folder containing all levels, control panels, and production view related adjustments. The launch panel is available in both setup and production view. The launch panel shows all levels and control panels of the project linked to your show. All changes made in the setup view are stored in the open show. Under show settings, here you can edit your project path, configure and calibrate your camera system, object tracking groups, video I/O, and routing, as well as launch levels and control panels. With Pixotope 2.0, we now support the following sources or destinations: Aja video cards, Blackmagic Design DeckLink video cards, File. This is an experimental new feature allowing for video playback from a local media file, and NDI. Under Production View, you also have the ability to launch levels and control panels, as well as our usual functionality, allowing you to enable the internal video keyer, adjust and transform the compositing planes, as well as how the 3D graphics and video are composited together. Adjust effects, allowing you to add various post-processing effects to the 3D graphics as well as video. Adjust color grading and white balance for 3D graphics, video, and final output. Adjust objects, allowing you to change the properties and make transformations to each object available in your open level. And control your running level using custom control panels. Now that we're familiar with the new features of Pixotope 2.0, it's time to get started. Please see our other video tutorials for a detailed step-by-step on how to get your project up and operational with Pixotope 2.0.